Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Chronicle of Infinity on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Chronicle of Infinity and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Chronicle of Infinity. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all my friends, to start we need to open our main web browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to the current URL I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type it, because I added the clickable link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We landed on this page on our own internet site of Usitility, exactly where we find here in-depth information on the way to download and install Chronicle of Infinity on PC. We scroll lower a tad and press on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on that link, we get to the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will load to enjoy the game Chronicle of Infinity on our PC. It is now obvious that we access a great deal of pros of running this emulator. Now we are on the way to start downloading the Chronicle of Infinity by simply clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on that button. And the download step takes no time at all. Voila! This is the download. It is a file to execute. The following step is to run the executable file. Okay, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the system. We said yes. I minimize the web browser to start to see the installation software much better. The installer is very simple. It is made up of two options, install, and setup path. I will clarify what setup path truly does. We only simply click on it. And we discover that we've got here the path where the emulator will be set up. If we need to vary this folder we are required to click on the browse option, so we pick another directory and set up the emulator exactly where we choose. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. Then, I click on back. And I just click on install. Now, there it is. The install commences and it's going to continue in the download of these MB which are shown on the computer screen. At the time you save it on your computer, it could be a bit more or less megabytes. The download rate may go faster or at a lower speed, determined by your type of connection and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. At the moment, they are running incredibly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has actually been started immediately. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will advance to the right and once it gets to the finish, the emulator can be started for the first time. In fact, the emulator is already started, here for the first time. Before we continue, as can be seen, it created two icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is definitely the only one we are concerned about. Anytime we have to operate Chronicle of Infinity on the PC, we twice click on this particular software icon and therefore use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's make the next phase, which is actually a must. And this is to entry the Google Play Store. And we'll mouse click on Play Store. As you can see the Google Play is presented. At this point we must sign in. At this moment, the moment we're right here, we are required to execute the following step that is absolutely mandatory. So we mouse click on Sign In. Now it announces, Checking Info. It might in some cases get stuck in, Checking Info, that's why it doesn't advance. If so, you should attempt to connect to your account after a few hours it's going to most certainly be solved. Now we shall provide our email and password. The email address has to be a Gmail email address as well as its associated password. For example, you make use of the very same email address you are using at the moment in your YouTube account. So that I am going to provide my info and I'll revisit immediately after I have accomplished it. That's it, information typed. Below is Google welcoming us and providing us their terms of service. We should approve them all by clicking, I agree. Next, it allow us to back up to the Google Cloud. You might leave it selected and it'll make a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you can utilize this feature if you wish. We simply click on accept. Google Play is started without need to open it manually and immediately. To install the application, we have to browse the Android emulator desktop by double-clicking on this app icon indicated green-colored. Now that we are exploring the desktop of that Android emulator, we observe that we find here the install app option. We click or double-click on the button. Here we access to the Android game. Let's quickly click on now on the install option that I am just showing now in green color. And it will initiate the software setup. At this time it should download on your laptop or computer and install the game app. It could take a bit of time or it may possibly be amazingly quickly. That all relies upon on the web connection. This has already completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this specific option that I am emphasizing in green, to be able to start Chronicle of Infinity for the first time. We are presently on the emulator desktop, and then we're about to just click this brand new Chronicle of Infinity app icon which was created. The Android game is started for the first time. Currently there we end up with it, I'm able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will talk about the sound level of this emulator. It is right here. We have the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we should turn on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This is simply the very first one. We simply click on this app icon that I'm identifying in green color. And the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. In case we like to play the app in full screen, we select this application icon. And we might presently be experiencing the video game in 100% screen mode. To quit the 100% screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we might currently end up being in normal display screen mode. Now I am ready to explain you the keys mapping which is certainly extremely helpful. That step we will be ready to operate the game app much more effortlessly. The first task is to click on this computer keyboard icon. And there you will have the ability to complete the appropriate adjustments. I'll go ahead and keep the standard settings, though if you want to improve this, you can easily achieve it with no problem. As you can see, the emulator is absolutely in our own language. In certain cases it happens that your emulator is launched in the improper language, for instance, in Mandarin. And consequently to set it up in the appropriate language we go there to the cogwheel. And right here throughout various other configurations, we just click the language drop down. We can also select the language we prefer, German, Chinese, and so forth. After the language is decided, we should save, the emulator will restart, and also the game, the next time we start it, will of course be in the preferred language. Now, you will find another thing that we need to take into account, and this is that we will receive a message from Google Mail telling that a different device has been connected with this Google account. It definitely will ask us if we're the ones who have associated with that device. Of course, we ought not be troubled, simply because the emulator is behaving like an Google Android electronic device. And to identify which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we arrive right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. And we browse here to the model selection. And there we discover that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for our video tutorial. I believe you appreciated it, particularly that everyone thought it was interesting. If so, bring it a superb thumb up, subscribe to the channel, and any comments, issues or suggestions, let them in the comment field down below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams every once in a while. You get it down below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of the online videos which are usually appearing on the suggestion of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the following online videos. Bye.